During the move, as you can see, my knife took a little bit of a beating. More the clip than the knife. Really, the knife worked out great, but the clip definitely lost a little bit of the anodization on it. So today I'm going to show you a different method of anodizing and a way to touch this up. So we'll kind of go through the process together here. So the first thing we need to do is take the clip off. If I'm not mistaken, these are T6 Torx. So we'll pop those screws off. Got a lot of Loctite on there, but we'll get the screws out of there and we'll go to the next step. Okay, now that we got the screws out, I'm going to take my Windex bath and just toss the screws in there to loosen up some of the Loctite that was on there. Now, I've got the clip off, and you can see some of the anodization has rubbed off there, kind of in the edges, and then it's got a few scratches on it. So to get those scratches out, if it wasn't scratched, I'd just be able to throw it into the Whink rust and stain remover that I showed you guys in the last video, and take the titanium down to bare metal, get the anodizing off. But since it's scratched, I'm actually going to have to take a little bit of sandpaper to that. So I'm going to start with a little lower grit and then move up to, I'm not exactly sure what grit this is, but it's definitely a little rougher sandpaper, and then we'll move up to 2500 grit after that before we re-anodize. Okay, you can see that grit pretty well took off all the scratches. So now we just want to use the 2500 to give it a good polish. Okay, now you can see that the scratches are gone, but it's got fingerprints and skin oils on it. So we're going to toss it into the Windex with the screws. Let it soak in there while we get prepped for the rest. All right, we've got our anodizing setup back. I need to get the distilled water, and if you're not familiar with how this process goes, give you a quick rundown. I like to use Windex to clean off all the fingerprints and the grease and all of that. Then in here we've got the Whink rust and stain remover, which actually etches the titanium. And then in here we will have some distilled water. I'm going to kind of recap what we got going on now. We've got anodizing tank, and we need to mix some baking soda in there for an electrolyte solution. Okay, so you can take a spoonful of baking soda, put it in there, and just mix it up the best you can. Once it looks like most of the baking soda is dissolved, you're good to go. Alright. So that's about good there. And the water in there is distilled water. You want to make sure you're always using distilled water for this. So then we've got our titanium wire. Okay, I got this off of eBay. It costs $1.53 or something to get this little bit of titanium wire, and we'll be using this to dip the clip with, and to hold on to the alligator clip. Then we've got our Whink rust and stain remover. Okay, and I don't have gloves on right now, but before I get started on this, I'm going to put some gloves on. You want to make sure you're always wearing gloves when you do this. For one, that Whink rust and stain remover is some really nasty stuff, and you do not want to get that on your skin. And then this is our Windex, and I think any glass cleaner will work, but basically we're using this to dissolve any fingerprints that are on there, and just kind of clean up the piece before we get to anodizing. You want your piece as clean as possible. If your piece isn't clean, you're going to get a bad anodizing job. Okay, so you want to get it super clean, and then when I pull this out of here, I'll have gloves on so my skin oils will not be getting onto the piece of titanium, because if you get your skin oils on there, then you're gonna have kind of a funky job there, and you don't want that. You want your anodizing to come out as best as you can possibly get it. And then we have just a regular just a dip cup of distilled water, and that's just kind of a rinse cup. All right, then of course we've got our alligator clips. All right, and we've got our trusty fork, and then we've got our batteries. Okay, so got my gloves on, ready to go. I'm gonna take and get the batteries set up. So for this, we want to do blue, and I believe what we did before was 3 batteries to get that blue, but we'll do it and see. So you connect your batteries together like so, okay, and then take your alligator clips, and we'll do red on positive. Black on negative. You want to keep your batteries away from your work. Okay, now we've got our piece of titanium wire wrapped through one of the screw holes. All right, so you want to immediately, once you bring it out of the Windex, you want to give it a bath in the distilled water. Okay. And then immediately from the distilled water, you want to put it in the Whink rust and stain remover to get the rest of the anodizing off. Okay, so, and this will actually etch the titanium just a little bit. And then I'll lift you guys up so you can see it. It will completely take that blue off, and then you'll start seeing it bubbling. Shake it around just a little bit to make sure all of it comes off, and then you want to pull it out and go right back into the distilled water bath. Okay, now we want to do it like that, because if we don't go right to the distilled water bath, then it'll continue etching the titanium, and the more it etches, the more titanium it removes. So you don't want to eat away at your titanium, you just want it etched, okay? So you want to shake it around in the distilled water, get all the little bubbles off of it, all right? And then you want to go straight from the distilled water bath into your anodizing bath. You don't want to let it come out and get water spots dried on it, but just to show you guys, it's completely bare now. All the anodizing's off, and it even took the polished finish down just a little bit, which is what we want. We don't want a super polished finish on it, because what that'll end up doing is making the anodizing a little bit of a different color, and that's not quite what we're looking for with this. So we're going to take our little square of sponge, okay, and we're going to toss that into the solution, get it nice and wet, all right? Then we're going to pull our piece out of the distilled water, and we're going to actually just dry that off, all right? Nice and dried off. All right, now you'll notice we still have our lead on the piece, okay? So we're going to take and connect the positive alligator clip to the lead, all right? And then we're going to take the negative and connect that to the sponge, like so, all right? And I'll get you in a little closer here. Now, what we're going to be able to do with the positive connected to the piece and the negative to the sponge, we're actually going to be able to paint on anodization, okay? So now you'll see you can make all sorts of different patterns with it. You can see the sponge makes different patterns. The longer you leave it, the darker it goes, okay? So, there's that, all right? And then you can take and throw it into your bath there. Let me zoom you back out. Whoop. Now you can see this method is good if you don't want to anodize the whole thing, or you want to make crazy patterns. You can actually take electrical tape and put it over top first and then cut stuff out of it, right? And then go over it with the sponge, and you'll be able to kind of titanium anodizing etch different things into your piece. So just a little trick I wanted to show you guys. Also, guys, remember, if anything comes out in a way that you don't like, say, you know, you had done what I just did here and didn't like the way it came out, you can always take and throw it in the Whink, pull the anodizing off, and then re-anodize it a different way. You know, so remember, none of this is permanent. You can always fix any mistakes that you've made. If you forgot a step, you can always go back and fix it. So just try to keep that in mind. Really, you know, we're just having fun, guys, messing around with this stuff. And I'm just trying to show you some ways to do it that won't cost you a fortune, you know. So if you could, for me, give me a like on this video. Subscribe if you haven't already. Leave a comment in the comments section. I try to answer all the comments that I get. If you got any questions on parts of the process, let me know. You know, I'll definitely get back to you. And other than that, you know, that's about all I got. Tell you again, I apologize for not getting this video out as soon as I wanted to. With the move, and then during the move I injured my back pretty bad, and then I couldn't find any of my equipment after the move. So just getting my shop set up and getting it the way I wanted to, and then finding everything I needed to do some of these videos. But we're good to go now. We're back in business, and we'll see you on the next one.